think Liv Morgan really wants to be her own star, her own player, so to speak.
Look at this. I like that sort of aggression. Notice Liv just driving her chin into the top of Ember Moon's skull. It's not going to win you the match, but it's incredibly painful.
And sticking out that blue tongue. I asked her earlier why she has a blue tongue. She told me, I like the color blue, dummy.
Hardcore Michael Cole journalism. Why do you have a blue tongue?
Creating some separation. But has the damage been done by Liv Morgan?
I'll tell you, that last maneuver probably drove most of the wind out of Liv Morgan's lungs. Ember Moon now with a moment to recover, compose herself. Which one of these two women will make it to their feet first?
Ember sidestepping Morgan.
Wow.
Oh, Liv, great move from behind.
That was sweet.
Bought herself some time to recover as well.
One thing that happens when you face the same opponent a couple of times, three or four times in a row, you start to understand what they're about. You do your
homework. Face first goes Morgan, and Ember Moon looks to rally. Starting to pick up the pace.
That is such a horrible feeling when you get that right up the nasal cavity. Oh, it could take you a couple of minutes to really.
You can't see, your eyes water up.
Yeah.
And Ember now using her power to her advantage, and there's the fallaway slam to Morgan. And Ember's fired up, and now Sarah Logan on the apron. Ember makes her pay. Ember Moon creating her own version of mayhem.
Oh, wait a minute, from behind.
Morgan, though, a roll through by Ember. Stacking up Liv Morgan. Jackknife cover, got her. Squad is not going to be happy about this. Ember Moon with a victory over the self-proclaimed problem child of WWE, Liv Morgan.
I'm always so impressed by Ember Moon. Not just that she gets the job done, but how she gets the job done. It's entertaining, athletic, everything under the roof.